Power BI is a great tool for analytics, but pulling in data from all the sources you need can sometimes be tricky. The number of natively supported integrations is limited, but fortunately, there are several ways to connect any API to Power BI. In this video, I'll walk you through the three most common approaches, break down their pros and cons, and show you a practical example so you can see them in action. Imagine I run a travel agency and I want a dashboard that displays the current weather at every destination my clients visit. To make that happen, I can integrate Power BI with an API, in this case, OpenWeather. This API is great for pulling real-time and historical weather data, as well as forecasts for almost any location worldwide. One of my clients' favorite spots is Gili Trawangan, a small Indonesian island just off the coast of Lombok. To get the current weather for this island, I need its coordinates, which I can easily get from Google Maps. I found the OpenWeather API endpoint for fetching current weather data and tested it in Postman, providing the coordinates and my API key as parameters. And here's the response. I'm particularly interested in the temperature data, including the feels like value. Air pressure and humidity will also be useful for my dashboard. So let's try the first method for bringing this data into Power BI, Coupler.io. Coupler.io is a no-code solution that allows you to connect almost any data source to Power BI and other platforms in a fully automated way. It supports over 60 integrations with marketing, sales, finance, and other business apps. For APIs that aren't natively supported, you can use the JSON integration, and if an API returns data in CSV format, the dedicated integration will work as well. Since the OpenWeather API returns JSON, I'll try that integration and simply paste the API URL into Coupler.io. Then in the query parameters, I'll add my API key along with the latitude and longitude values. And here are the results. Let's clean them up to keep only the relevant fields and remove unnecessary columns. By default, OpenWeather provides temperature values in Kelvin, which probably isn't the unit system that you use every day. I could request the data in Celsius or Fahrenheit by adding another API parameter, but I can also handle the conversion directly in Coupler.io. Let's transform the temperature to Celsius, rename the columns, and adjust the layout before sending the dataset to Power BI. To do that, I'll generate and copy an integration URL. Before jumping into Power BI, it's worth scheduling automatic data refreshes. Let's say I want to pull fresh weather data daily at 6 a.m. Central European time, which is midday in Indonesia. To set up this integration in Power BI, click on Get Data, select Web, and paste in the URL. Now here's the imported data in Power Query. Click Close and Apply, and the data will appear in the data pane on the right, ready for analysis. Coupler.io is an excellent choice for anyone who wants to set up quick, automated API integrations with Power BI without writing code. You don't have to worry about infrastructure, scheduling, or maintenance. Once the integration is configured, it runs automatically. It's also great for data cleaning, especially when an API returns a ton of unnecessary fields. As I showed earlier, you can filter, transform, and even join data from multiple sources before it ever reaches Power BI. Let's say I want to fetch weather data for another location, something really cold for a change. I heard there's a weather station somewhere in Antarctica and OpenWeather should have some data for it. To collect that, all I need to do is duplicate my data flow. Now I'll just swap in the right coordinates and load the preview. Wow, it is not as cold as I expected. Well, it is summer there after all. Coupler.io also allows you to append data from multiple sources, which would make sense here. And keeping the coordinates for each location would make the dataset even more useful. If needed, you can also join data from different API endpoints or connect it with data from other supported apps. And if performance is a concern, you can pre-aggregate data before sending it to Power BI, which speeds up analysis. What about the downsides? While there is a free plan, connecting multiple sources or accessing advanced features may require a paid subscription. And compared to writing custom code, Coupler.io does have some limitations. For example, it doesn't support pagination, rotating OAuth tokens, or certain complex API behaviors. However, for most users and the majority of APIs, it will do just fine. Now let's explore another approach, one that's built directly into Power BI. Using the same web option as before, you can connect an endpoint to Power BI by specifying parameters directly in the URL. For simple API requests like the one that I'm working with, this method works just fine. Click OK and the data will load into Power Query and then into Power BI. This method is great for straightforward API calls, those that don't rely on OAuth, don't require advanced automation, and return a manageable amount of data. Automation is possible, but it requires Power Query's built-in functions, which can be cumbersome to configure. The biggest advantage? It's completely free, aside from any API-specific costs that you might incur. However, there are some major downsides. First, this method isn't scalable. If you want to pull weather data for 20 different locations, you'll have to create 20 separate queries and manually combine them in Power Query, which is far from ideal. Another issue is data volume. This approach imports everything the endpoint returns for the given parameters. If an API outputs hundreds of columns, but you only require a handful, cleaning that up in Power Query is far from efficient. You'll also run into trouble if the API has rate limits, requires OAuth authentication, or involves dynamic parameters. That's where our third approach comes in, writing a custom script. A common approach is to fetch data via a script, store it in a data warehouse or database, process it, and then load it into Power BI. Here's a simple Python script that pulls the same weather data from OpenWeather API and returns a data frame. It then sends the data to BigQuery, appending it to a selected table. And here's a sample execution. Once the data is in BigQuery, you can load it into Power BI by opening Get Data, selecting BigQuery, and choosing your table. You can either import the data once or use Direct Query to ensure it refreshes automatically. Another option is to push data directly to Power BI using its REST API, which is great for real-time data streaming. However, this method comes with some serious limitations. You can only send data using Power BI's push datasets method, which doesn't support relationships or joins, meaning complex data models must be flattened before ingestion. All transformations must happen before ingestion. Power BI's can't apply SQL-like queries to push datasets, which can significantly limit your options. And finally, API rate limits can also make it difficult to work with large datasets. Whether you send data directly to Power BI or via a data warehouse, custom scripts provide unmatched flexibility compared to the other two options. They let you integrate with any API, manage advanced authentication, implement error handling, and pre-process data before it even reaches Power BI. If you're working with big data, a data warehouse solution like BigQuery helps ensure you only load what you need and in the most optimized format. The downside? Complexity. Unlike the other methods, this approach requires writing and maintaining code, setting up infrastructure, managing scheduling and API failures, and securely storing API keys. That's why it's best for custom and large-scale integrations. If your needs are simpler, a ready-made solution will be much easier to manage. So let's sum it up. Each approach has its pros and cons, so which one is right for you? If your API has simple parameters and static data and doesn't need automation, then directly connecting via Power BI's web option is the easiest choice. It's quick, free, and works well for one-time imports. If you need scheduled updates, advanced data transformation, and a user-friendly setup, Coupler.io strikes a great balance between ease of use and automation. You can set up automatic data refreshes on your desired schedule, and its intuitive interface lets you clean, filter, and transform data without any coding. It also allows you to integrate data from multiple sources, join or append data, and perform aggregations all before sending it to Power BI. This makes Coupler.io an ideal solution for users who want powerful automated API connections without the complexity of custom scripts. But if you require custom API integrations, need to handle large data sets, or have more complex authentication needs, then consider writing your own script. This approach gives you full control over API interactions, allowing for fine-tuned error handling, token management, and data optimizations. What's more, writing your own script ensures that you can easily implement custom business logic and integrate data from multiple sources or endpoints in ways that off-the-shelf solutions might not support. And that's it. Now you know how to connect APIs to Power BI using different methods. If you have any questions, please feel free to drop them in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please like, share, and subscribe so you never miss new content. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.